What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to another vlog. I'm currently in the daily right now, as you can see. I have a painting back there, ignore it. But yeah, I just got off work, and I feel like I start off every vlog getting off of work. Is it just me? That's not good. You can't even, why the hell are you trying to turn here? You know your big ass truck, you can't make that little ass turn. Come on, man. This guy's reversing. I don't want to reverse because I'm gonna hit the guy in the back of me. All bad. Dude over here with his bass boosting ass. Let me go around this dude. Come on now, hold the fuck on. I am the wrong for not letting him go. I don't think so, because what is the point? Why are you trying to turn there anyways? Go through a wider street. There's more than one way to get to where you're going, I promise you. Like, I'm not hating or whatever, but like, why are you turning in like a narrow ass street? You don't fit, man. You don't fit. I don't know, maybe he's not from the area, so I'm gonna give it to him. Seeing it once again, it's so good. And yes, I know my windshield is cracked, I need to get that fixed. And also the check engine light, I already know what code it's throwing up, and I already know what the fuck is going on. Oh, I was pressing this. Which one did I have it at? I think I had it at that one. Miles till E, or distance till E. But yeah, I already got it red. I know what code it is, I know what part it is, I have the paper, I have the cost of the part that I need, and it's not too bad. It's only like, what, like $130? I believe it was one of the oxygen sensors in bank 2, I believe is what it says. I'm not sure, I need to check the paper, but I don't know how to do that, but I'm gonna look it up because I'm gonna try to do it myself, and if I don't do it correctly or something, then I'll take it to someone's. But I might as well try, right? I'm never gonna learn if I don't try. I'm gonna try and make this video quick because it's getting dark soon, as you can see, and I think it's been raining all day and I don't want it to pour more while my phone is on the tripod. So hold on. As you can tell by the title of this video, this is an about my daily driver 2012 Ford Focus hatchback in this very strange color, teal, light blue, green, whatever you want to call it. There is a lot of wind going on, but I'm not gonna get like too much into detail, like specs and all, because it's a Ford Focus. Like, what do you expect from it? There's not much to know about it besides it's like a hatchback. It has a back door that lifts up. It's not just like a trunk, you know, basically a five-door car, you know. So the reason I got this car, I think I've had it almost 4 years now, and I wasn't in like the best situation ever, so I couldn't be picky about the car that I chose. I also didn't have cash up front to buy whatever car, so I had to finance this like 9 to 10K, which wasn't too bad considering the credit I had at the moment. But anyways, we're not gonna get into that. So I couldn't be picky, I couldn't pick and choose what I wanted. Did I want to? Yes. Would I have gotten this car had I had the option to choose? Yes.
Obviously I meant no.
But that was not the case at the moment. But yeah, here it is. It's a 2012 Ford Focus hatchback. It's taken care of me for the past 3 years. My tripod just fell. It's been super reliable. So let's just do a quick walk around. And this isn't gonna be like a long video. I'm gonna try to quick the details of the Ford Focus. The Ford Focus. This lighting is so much better, I can't get over it. All right, under the hood, we got a turbo pushing 5 pounds. Ah, damn. Nice as fuck. Clean ass engine bay, wire tucked, 4-cylinder. That's about the only truth right there. No, but for real, this thing is a gas saver. Not a gas guzzler, a gas saver, which is why this is the daily now, because, dang, all I did was open the shoes.
I mean, obviously it's been my daily for the past 4 years, or close to 4 years, but now that I have the BRZ, this really is my daily, because I don't daily the BRZ. BRZ is also a four cylinder, but it wastes more gas than the Focus. Now some quick details about it. Fog lights, headlights. I don't know what happened here. I woke up one morning and noticed that this was broken. I'm pretty sure somebody hit it and just ran off without saying anything. Is it annoying? Yeah. Do I care? Not really, because it doesn't affect the drivability of it. If you haven't seen any of my other videos, then you don't know why I have a yellow side view mirror, passenger side view mirror. But I mean, obviously the original one is gone and I had to settle for a yellow mirror. So long story short, we were driving to work. I hit a trash can, boom. Flew off, went back to look for it, gone. Couldn't find it. But a week or two ago, my dad and I went to a junkyard to look for Ford Focuses that had a functioning, well-maintained, not well-maintained, but like intact, like full mirror and everything. Full mirror. Everything works. The electrical components, the turn signal. The wind got really bad in this part of the video, but I'm basically saying that I was a little disappointed that it was yellow. I was hoping for a white or a black one, but yeah, it was the only option, so that's why I took it. It had the complete mirror intact, so I had no choice but to get that one. I made a junkyard shopping video on that if you want to check it out. Alloy wheels, four doors, five door, fifth door right here. I'm about sick of this wind ruining my video, but anyways, another favorite feature on this car is that it has a rear windshield wiper, and that's super, super helpful when it rains or it snows. The SEL model. I believe that's not a super like lower level trim, and it's also not like a premium. Now let's go into the cockpit. So this is an automatic. Would I have preferred a 6-speed? As a daily, probably not. Well, truth be told, I would have wanted a 6-speed or a 5-speed even as a daily manual transmission. But like I said, I couldn't be picky. I didn't have options, so this works. If I ever get another daily, it would probably be a manual, so, and then I'd have three cars. I honestly had two options for cars. It was either this Ford Focus or a 2014 Hyundai Elantra, and I test drove both of them, and honestly went with the Ford Focus just for the simple fact that it was leather seats and it had like a touchscreen. Overall, the interior of this one was much nicer. It felt like a much newer car to me. This doesn't feel like a 2012 car in the interior. It feels like 2015, 2016, you know? And the other, the Elantra, felt like a 2006. Yeah, like I mentioned before, this thing is super good on gas. I like the screen. It's very roomy. It's very spacious. I also like that it has electric seats. So if you remember in the beginning of the video, if someone could please explain what is going on with this car, how I explained how there was the check engine light, it'll go turn on for like a few days and then it'll turn off again. So I'm like, is my check engine light on or is it not on? Is it just playing tricks on me? Do I really need to change the oxygen sensor? What is going on? If you guys can help me out with that, I guess I could do a simple Google search, but I mean, if you guys know what's going on with that, please leave a comment down below and let me know. Or if you have like any idea, you don't have to be right, you don't have to, even if you're wrong or right, just throw some ideas out there. But yeah, look. Okay, so this one doesn't even work anymore, but blue lights, those lights change, those colors change. I think this one, yeah, red, orange, green, purple, yellow, red. So yeah. Oh, it'll also change the colors here too. I forgot it changes colors there too. I thought that was a pretty cool feature. But yeah, hella good on gas. It fills up with like $20 to $25. It really just depends on gas prices. And heated seats. If it snows where you live, that's like deal breaker. That means it's cold there. Heated seats, big must.
Another pretty cool feature on this car is that the side view mirrors are heated. So if there's frost or if there's like frozen water on it, you'll just hit this button and it'll slowly melt off the ice or the fog or whatever it is, just like as if it were your windshield. Leather tan-ish seats, they're more like a beige. So this is also the car we use to take the dogs to the park, which is why there's a dog seat cover on here.
The sound quality in this car to listen to music is pretty fucking good. The bass is pretty good. Honestly, the sound in the music is a lot better in this car than it is in the BRZ, and the BRZ is newer. Yeah, there's not really much I can tell you guys. AM radio, FM radio, Sirius. Okay, how do you pronounce that? Series or Sirius? I don't know. CD, USB, Bluetooth, SD card, AVN. All right, guys, I do want to mention one more thing. I'm not sure how many people still watch my video. Those two who were subscribed to me like 5+ years ago. But if you're watching this and you were, even if you didn't watch my videos and you're now just now discovering my channel, my first car that I started making content with on YouTube was a 2005 Infiniti G35 coupe in pearl white. I loved that thing to death. It was a automatic transmission. That was the first car that I ever started modding. And then I had like a 1999 Jeep Cherokee, and then I got this car. This car right here, that Ford Focus right there, is one of the reasons why I stopped making YouTube videos. I didn't want to make car content about a Ford Focus hatchback, so I didn't want to make videos about it. I was broke as broke. I had no motivation, I had no inspiration. All the creativity for me went out the door. I got like, I wouldn't say depressed, but I was in a really deep funk with myself for the longest, even after I got this car. That's like the biggest reason why I stopped making YouTube videos for almost 4 years, because the last video I made with the G35 was drifting the G35 gone wrong, loud noises. I was sad about it. I still get sad about it thinking about it, because I missed the G35 greatly, and I'm gonna make a video on that also.
But honestly, man, I wish I never stopped making YouTube videos, because I really enjoyed it. Like, I really enjoy it now. I could have found other things to make content about, like car content. Like, I could have gone to meets, I could have gone to track days, I could have gone to drift days, I could have gone to rallies, I could have done anything, but I was down in the dumps. Yeah, I'm making content again. I enjoy it. I hope you guys enjoy it. If you're a returning subscriber, if you're a new subscriber, if you're not subscribed to me, and if you like my videos, subscribe, hit that bell, leave a comment, like, share, all that.
Let's get this car warm. There you have it. I hope you guys enjoyed my daily driver, my 2012 Ford Focus hatchback. And that's about all I have for you guys. I'm sorry if this was a little boring, but I mean, I kind of just want to share my other car, which is this one, my daily driver, and like my reasons as to why I got this one. I just want you guys to know more about me and my things. And yeah, I'll catch you guys in the next one.